Skincare is really important, so I really would recommend you not to try cover up everything that's going on under your skin with makeup, because it's not going to solve the problem, it's only going to make it worse. So please make sure you really take care of your skin, moisturize it, make sure it's nice and healthy and glowing. And then first step is we are going to go in with our primer. So I'm going to use my Maybelline Baby Skin Primer, and this is Instant Pore Eraser, and it's a very nice lightweight primer. So I'm just gonna put a dime size. And if you have oily skin, I would recommend that you apply it more, particularly where you get oily, maybe to your T-zone, wherever it is. So I'm just gonna apply it all over my face. So as you've noticed, I have done my eyebrows. I like to do my eyebrows first before I do my foundation. It's just easier for me, but do what is suitable for you. I have normal skin. Sometimes I have dry skin in the winter, but I've never had oily skin, so I'm not too particular in that department. When we are done with that, we are going to use concealer. So I like to use my Allegro Pro Conceal in the shade Warm Honey. So we are going to cover up any dark marks, dark circles, aka Gucci bags under our eyes. So anything that you want to conceal on your face, you're going to put concealer in those areas. So I'm going to go in under my eyes, and then I also have some dark marks on my nose, so I'm just going to conceal there as well. I'm also going to conceal around my mouth because it is a bit dark. Now I'm going to take a damp sponge. So you can use a sponge or you can use a fluffy brush. I like to use a damp sponge, and I'm just going to pat the concealer in. So you don't want to use a swiping motion, because now that's going to move the concealer from where you want it to cover the mark. So you want to dab so the concealer just stays in that place. If you're happy with it, then you can stop right there, but I'm gonna go back with some concealer because these Gucci bags don't want to leave me alone. So this is just an extra step that I like to do. You do not have to do it. I just really like to have really bright under eyes, and it makes you look more awake. And guys, I love sleeping. Okay, I really get my beauty sleep on, so I don't know how I have these Gucci bags. I really, really love this Allegro Pro Conceal. It is just so creamy and really easy to work with. You can get it at Discare, and the last time I checked, it retails for 60 Rand. So actually, it's really, really affordable. And the best in the market. I mean, so many people use the Allegro Pro Conceal because it really, it just does the job. It does the job. Okay, so now that we've gotten rid of the dark circles and the spots on the nose, now we are gonna go in with the foundation. So I like to use two tools, that stippling brush and my beauty sponge. So the beauty sponge is not really necessary. You can use either or if you don't have the other one. But why I like to use both of them is because sometimes the brush maybe does leave a bit of streaks behind. So then that's when you go in with your sponge and it just clears that all away. And you really, really need to get really good tools, because that will also determine how flawless your foundation is. So with testing foundation, finding the right shade for your skin type, it is better to test it on your neck, or from your face going down to your neck, than to test it on your hand, because your hand and your face are two different shades, because obviously the sun hits those areas differently. So if you want to get the correct shade for your skin type, ask someone in the shop to assist you when you are buying your foundation and test it going down to your neck. And also test it out in different lighting, like when you're outside or when you are indoors, because sometimes it is a bit different. And also, something that is also important is the foundation that you use in summer is not necessarily sometimes the foundation that you'll use in winter, because in winter you are lighter, there's not much sunlight, and like in summer we get a tan, we look a bit more darker. So just take note of that as well. I'm going to use the Fit Me Maybelline Matte Poreless Foundation. I do not have my correct shade, so I'm going to mix these two colors. So this is 332 and this is 350. So together it gives me the perfect shade. What I love about these foundations is that it is just so lightweight. I mean, it doesn't even feel like you have foundation on. And that's exactly what you want, especially in the summer. In the winter, it's okay to go full coverage, but I don't know, I have my days where I want to go full coverage, and then I have my days where I just want to have really minimal makeup, but I still want to look like I have something on and have a beat face. So these two colors together gives me the perfect shade. So now with your foundation, you want to use a dabbing motion as well. So you don't want to swipe it, as it's going to leave streaks and it's just not going to look cute and give you that flawless look that you are looking for. So let's start with the cheek area. So this foundation doesn't dry quickly, so you really can take your time with blending it. So I'm going to go down, so don't forget the neck. And also your ears. A lot of people don't do it, but I think it's so important, because if your ears are really just standing out and you can see that it is a different color, then it's awkward. But my ears are covered, so I'm not gonna do my ears. But if your ears are out, you would want to cover them up. So you just want to use a dabbing motion. And I really, really love this technique. It really just gives you a flawless finish. You also just want to push the foundation into your hairline so it doesn't look like you're wearing a mask. Also, the importance of taking it down to your neck. The next step is to take your beauty sponge and to just pat everything in, just so that it looks flawless and seamless. So I like using the foundation brush first, because it doesn't take up a lot of product. Unlike the beauty blender, it really soaks up a lot of product in it, and it's just such a waste. So it's nice to just go in with the brush first and then take the beauty blender just to blend everything in. And it gives you such a flawless finish, really. I love it. If you're done with that, the next step is to go in with powder. So I'm going to use my Mineralize Skin Finish from MAC. You don't have to get this product specifically. You can get any pressed powder in your shade. And we're just going to pat it in and just apply it all over the face. So I'm just going to use the foundation brush. Now this just locks the foundation in, and it gives us a flawless finish. When you are done with that, you're gonna go in with your setting spray. So I'm gonna use this one from NYX, and it is Dewy Finish. Just let it dry. Woo! Makes me wanna sneeze. Don't drown yourself in it if you're not used to it, because while it is a lot sometimes. And there you have it. Flawless foundation routine. I hope these were really easy steps that you can follow. Try it at home. Let me know how it works out. And just remember, makeup is just about practicing, practicing, practicing. And I know you've heard it 1,000 times, but it's with everything in life. You just need to practice. The more you practice, the more you get better at it. So before I close out today's video, I would just like to give a subscriber shout out to Armando Leonjanga. So thank you so much for subscribing to the family. If you would like a shout out, please just hit the red button down below. and it could be you one of these days. So without further ado, I have to love and leave you guys, but may your day be ever flawless as your makeup. And thank you so much for your love and support. Bye.